I'm gonna share what I shared the other night when we had our budget meeting, that I am a football coach, and as a football coach, I share that I get called a whole lot of names as a football coach, and I share especially when we're not winning football games, I get called even harsher names. But I shared that to share this, that I am an educator. I work in the school system. I worked in the school system for 17 years, and I've passed one budget since I've been in the school system. And that budget that I passed last year, I sit down with our city manager, I sit down with our budget director, Ms. Lisa, and I wanted to make sure that the additional funds that were going to the school system would be sufficient enough for them to fund a 3% raise. Well, those new funds that went to the school system weren't enough, to my dismay. And then being in the position that I'm in, I now went from having co-workers and colleagues who are friends, some I consider family members, now they look at me as a foe because they think that I don't understand the plight, or not fully understand the plight of an educator here in our city. What I want us to fully fund the school system in a 4% raise? Yes, I would. I want them to be able to fully fund it because I know the hard work that goes into being an educator and some of the experiences that they have to go through in regards to their salaries that they receive. Now, going back to my statement that I said in the prior question, I need to be able to get an actual of what's going on. Because right now, what I'm seeing is a discrepancy between two entities, as was stated earlier, that makes it look, for lack of better words, childish among two governing bodies, not being able to sit down together, which I have continued, I will continue to request that. We sit down to see what can be done to better fund our school system, what can be done in the city council side of the budget to make sure that we can make this a priority for our educators to be fully funded. Thank you.
Great. I'm gonna let Mayor Price respond, but also I want to come back to Mr. Green and Councilman Harris. I didn't hear you say yes or no, and so I'm going to give you all an opportunity to come back for first, Mayor Price.
Yeah, I just wanted to make the statement about where you said that the year end that it was too late to give teachers a raises. My feeling is on the budget, if you have a surplus, then you should return that to the city as the code states that you should. We could then reallocate those funds if a request is needed for the raises back to the school system.
Great. Okay, Mr. Green, yes or no?
Yes.
Okay.
The answer is yes.
Okay, Councilman Harris?
Yes, I thought I said yes, but I'll say it one more time.
Maybe I just missed it. Let me follow up now. Let me just dig a little deeper into this. It's really a new question, but it's a follow-up to this. It has recently come to light that for the past several years, the school system has budgeted more, millions more sometimes, for human resources than has been spent. And each year, some of that money has been shifted over to pay for other things, one-time things such as building repairs and maintenance. While nothing illegal with this, some have argued that this practice, year after year, of budgeting more than is actually being spent on human resources and then shifting that extra money over to other needs, makes the argument that the city should provide more funding for raises a hard one to justify. Is this the case? Is this the confusion? And if it is, what's the answer? Mr. Green, and then Mr. Creekmore, and then the line.
Yeah, so you put me in a tough spot because you're asking me to validate data which I haven't seen. And so let's just assume that the data says that there is that sort of internal operations that's going on within the school board. I actually work with companies all the time, so that's my job. I go into a company, and the first thing I get asked from a CEO or VP is, how do we succeed? We're failing, we either are falling behind because we're not competitive, or we're not managing our cost effectively, or we need better knowledge, or we need better talent, right? Those are kind of some of the levers that typically get put in front of me to help a company succeed. The same is true for our school board. The fact is the evidence or the proof is in the pudding when you look at the fact that our school system is not doing well, our students are not doing well. So now we have to looking at the data that you said exists, why is that? And if we can't come to a conclusion about why our school system is not doing well, that's when I think the city council should step in. But I think there's an overreach here. There's a lack of trust, and we just heard it, between the city council and the school board. Perhaps the school board doesn't think they're going to get the continuous funding that they need. Perhaps the city council also does the same thing. And perhaps the school board, just as you have evidence, believes that the city council is also stashing away money or misallocating money. And so it's a fundamental question of trust. And the better that we get at being transparent and improving those relationships, which is something that I'm very good at, improving relationships, building trust through the people that I work with, the more effective the school board and city council will be working together. But those two main areas, trust and transparency, are really hurting us right now.
Great. All right, Mr.